Oh, hello. I didn't see you there. Welcome to Don't Talk to Robots Presents. In this episode, we go back in time to highlight one of the Pacific Northwest's most prolific basketball players. This film, which some may call a documentary, cobbles together VHS footage, radio broadcasts, parental interviews, and even some amateur commercials to tell the story of one of the most prolific basketball treasures of our generation, Andy Vander Meulen, or who you might know as none other than Flying Dutchman Cards. But did you know he once went by a very different name? Join us as we share the 2004 film, The MEUL. Little has changed in the life of the common work mule over centuries of time. The crossbreed of a horse and a donkey, the mule is ideal for difficult and trying work situations. While not the most elegant or graceful of the equidae family, the mule is a valued component in the great circle of life. Little has changed for the mule until the year of 1989. MC Hammer was gaining in popularity, and a portly Andy Vander Meulen first laced up a pair of basketball sneakers and hit the court. Growing up mere feet from a full-sized basketball court served the young Andy well as he began to hone his now legendary skills. Few know of these humble beginnings, in which Andy Vander Meulen took his first gallops into becoming the man, the myth, the mule, by which he is now known of worldwide. Join us as we chronicle the career of one of the most prolific and inspirational players the Pacific Northwest and Southern British Columbia has ever seen, the man known as the Mule.
Beyond the Glory on FSN is brought to you by
Mylanta.
Oh, Martha. Oh, George. Oh, Martha. Bob? No, George! Oh, George! Oh, Martha! Oh! George! No! With you! Sorry, Martha.
He should have used my letter. Here you go, kid.
Hey.
Hey, give it back.
Hey, I got it. Ooh, cool mint. My favorite. Yeah, thanks. George, can I use some of that?
Andy, hear me roar.
The man known as the Mule. Where did this basketball player of mythical proportion come from? Originally born in Grand Rapids, Michigan, Andy Vander Meulen was the second son of Barb and Bruce Vander Meulen. Moving to Bellingham at the age of 3, the Vander Meulens settled in at the Furs, a Christian conference center. The Furs' basketball court hosted some fierce competition for young Andy and provided a training ground for his new interest in sports. Starting in third grade, Andy became involved in soccer, basketball, and baseball. While he continued to play soccer and baseball further into his schooling career, it quickly became evident that basketball was his passion. Joining a boys and girls club team with fellow third graders, Andy's height immediately paid dividends as he laid the foundation to become a great defensive player. While not always an offensive threat, the bright shimmer of a future post player could be seen in Andy's eyes. His family noticed his potential as they cheered from the sidelines, a tradition that would follow Andy throughout his career.
As Andy was growing up, as we watched him from third grade on, we have been to every single game that he's ever played, but Dad really didn't like a lot of the refs when he was in third grade, fourth grade, fifth grade, and on up. And so we found early on, as him and Mike Messing almost got ejected from the game, and a technical point on the other team because they were yelling at the refs so much, we found that we had to give Dad jobs at the game, and one of them was making him take stats. And the other thing we did, we decided that if we did gave him suckers, that he could keep his mouth busy eating lollipops. So we were kind of known as the parents that always had lollipops in our pockets so Bruce would be quiet, and then we gave him jobs to do also.
He's big. Very big. Very, very big. He's Andy. I slam over him.
Andy continued to grow in his skills and confidence as he moved through the ranks of the Boys and Girls Club. In 1994, Andy started to pull double duty as he played for his Boys and Girls Club team as well as his 6th grade Culshan Middle School Thunderbirds. As he entered 8th grade, Andy faced one of his most difficult trials. A key to high school success in Andy's hometown of Bellingham was making the AAU team.
I think one of the funnest times was Andy going for the tryouts for AAU. And I think he was really nervous. And then when he made the team, it really boosted his confidence. But that, I think, was a real stepping stone for Andy to move on and be able to play in high school and then on in college. And I can attribute it all to that big confidence booster of making the AAU team.
A new ball?
Yep. Hey, Michelle, I got an idea. I'll play you for your ball.
Was 1996, and Andy's hard work and training paid off as he was picked for the Sehome High School Mariners freshman team. Short shorts were of no concern for Andy while he continued to grow as an all-around player.
He was also growing physically, sprouting to 6 feet 8 inches, 220 pounds during his high school career. The goggles weren't fooling anyone, as his reputation of being a defensive stopper quickly permeated the league. Playing swing his junior year was a great learning experience for Andy, getting time on both the JV and varsity squad. But was Andy and his team ready to face one of their most difficult challenges? This year had the possibility of a so-called Battle of the Titans. Andy's older brother Doug had stepped out of the glamour of high school basketball and played on a club team called the Mavericks. There was in the works a scrimmage between the Mavericks and Andy's team, the Sehome Mariners, but mysteriously, the Mariners backed out at the last moment. The rumor is that the Mariner organization was afraid the Mavericks might trample them and cause them to lose all confidence for the rest of the season. And so the outcome of this potential mythic game will never be known.
One of Andy's worst injuries happened when he was up at a camp at Western Washington.
It was the first injury I ever saw Andy really actually get in basketball.
Andy was playing really well and really dominating inside. Guy had a breakaway and Andy went down. He went up to block this guy's shot. I mean, the guy didn't have a chance of making the shot, and the guy just ducked under him and took out his feet. And Andy did a face plant, put his tooth through his lip, and then broke a tooth, and it was kind of ugly, but the hardest part was watching his mom sit there.
I immediately wanted to jump up and go over and make sure he was all right, and Bruce was holding me back because the coaches go on the floor, not the parents.
He's hurt, we gotta get over there. I said, Mom, we can't do that now, you gotta wait till, you know, the people are there, they're gonna take care of him. And then we went and got him. And
as they were sewing him up, he was in no pain or anything like that, but I almost fainted because of the watching the needle go in and out of his lip. So it was a real memorable moment for me also.
Everybody hurts sometimes. Sometimes everything
is a situation for the fifth-ranked Mariners having to come from behind in the second half in their regular season contest with Kamiak. Down four in the fourth, and Ian Gibbs drilling the clutch 15-footer. Then time running down in the game, and Andy Vander Meulen comes up huge, the tip and the foul off Kyle Jackson's miss. We're going to overtime. In the extra period, Sehome down a bucket, and Kyle Jackson changes that. The money ball from beyond the arc. Sehome gets the W, 68-64. They hit him with a real season with the momentum.
Andy making Sehome's varsity team in 1999, he started a steady habit of timely putback dunks.
During Andy's high school career, he had quite a few nice dunks. He had some at Sehome, he had a really nice one at Cascade, but the one we remember the most is the one at State. He went up out for a rebound after a long shot, grabbed the ball out of the air and threw it down. I think one of the things that really makes it memorable for us is, of course, the place went nuts, but our friends over in Spokane saw it on the news that night, and so that made it special too.
You mentioned everybody getting into the act, and it's rare that you get, maybe your 10th or 11th man off of the bench to turn in the play of the game, but it was indeed turned in by the big 6'8 post player, Andy Vander Meulen. Ask Kelly finds Friedrich over in the corner. Oh, good! Andy Vander Meulen with the cram jam on the follow and the crowd goes nuts.
Look at the big fella playing it cool as he comes the other way. The follow jam, sweet play by Andy Vander Meulen. They love it across the way.
And look at the bench. All the starters laughing and going crazy.
Is that a smile on Fitterer?
It was indeed a smile on Pat Fitterer's face. You mentioned the post-game conversation. They'll be chatting about that in practice for quite some time.
I like that. It brought
down
the house.
Big jam dunk from Andy Vander Meulen off of the missed three ball attempt by Frederick.
Upon graduation, Andy's future looked bright.
It'll hurt if I swallow. It'll hurt if I swallow. Will it hurt if I swallow? Am I getting paid for this commercial? Oh, maybe it would hurt if I swallow. Maybe I should try. Will it hurt or won't it hurt? Mommy!
After graduation, Andy was recruited from several colleges, but decided to go north of the border and join the sleeveless, sweater-wearing coach, Stan Peters, and the Trinity Western Spartans. Due to some international disagreements between the U.S. and Canada, Andy played peacekeeper, agreeing to redshirt his first year, thus avoiding the total cultural breakdown of the Great White North. Andy used his redshirting year to grow in his abilities, something that came in handy early in his second season. Coach Stan Peters stated, "Andy has been our most improved player this year. After Ben Bauman injured his back at the end of October, Andy has stepped into the starting lineup, taking advantage of the opportunity to play significant minutes. The thing that allows Andy to improve is his attitude. He listens and develops new habits, which is not a common attribute. I believe that once Andy develops physically and gains more confidence, he will become one of the top young post players in our conference." Andy went to Ireland after the regular season with Athletes in Action and used his basketball skills to share his relationship with Christ and solidifying his international star status. Now with experience starting, the 2002-2003 season became a breakthrough year for Andy and the Spartans. While sharing the starting post position, Andy was a dominant player and a key defensive stopper late in the game.
I think one of Andy's best college games was at Simon Fraser. It was a big deal. Simon Fraser had been ranked number one in the country. So when they introduced the team, they made this big deal of it, turned off the lights. It was a big, big deal. Trinity Western Spartans came in there, played very well, played well as a team, and ended up beating them quite handily. But the best part was watching Andy set the picks on their guard, who was on his backside most of the night, just because Andy just set a pick and no one would tell him, and down he'd go.
Playing teams from much larger schools, the Spartans were able to make it to the playoffs for the first time in many years. The Spartans and Andy's success spawned a dedicated fan base in Langley, BC, where Andy received the nickname MEUL, and fan websites started to pop up everywhere. While not achieving the success they hoped for during the 2003-2004 season, Andy was coming into his own, having one of the best seasons of his career. Adam Friesen and Andy Vander Meulen
12 points on 6 of 7 shooting, 9 rebounds, led the Spartans. "That was the best game that Andy has played as a Spartan," said Coach Peters. "The guys played in a good flow tonight," said TWU head coach Stan Peters. "Andy Vander Meulen played really well for us, and we're looking forward to Manitoba tomorrow night." The very next play was all Andy Vander Meulen. First, he grabbed a tough rebound on the defensive end and sent the outlet pass to Adam Friesen, who took off running and then dished a tough pass in the lane to a trailing Vander Meulen, who completed that acrobatic lay-in to extend the lead to 4. Vander Meulen started in place of the injured Logan Kitterham and filled in admirably, pulling down a game-high 12 rebounds as well as 2 points, 1 assist, and 1 block. A player like Andy Vander Meulen is invaluable to his teammates because he does a lot of the little things that perhaps go unnoticed to the untrained eye, but ensure that his team will have a good chance to come out on top. His defense against the opposition's big man, his deft passing touch, and his effort on the boards to either tip in the loose ball, a skill in which he excels, or grab the defensive rebound, are all a part of his role on the Spartan men's basketball team. Of course, he occasionally can't resist getting the Spartan faithful up on their feet and roaring with a timely putback dunk, despite his father's sage advice. "He always tells me, play hard, have fun, and don't hang on the rim," Andy said. "I usually do the first two, but I've gotten in trouble with him a couple of times for getting technicals for accidentally hanging on the rim."
One thing I've learned about watching both boys play basketball, and especially Andy, because he went on a few more years than Doug, but as he went to college, I decided that I was going to give my all into being a fan. And I've definitely made a mark at Trinity Western for probably being the loudest mom in the entire gym. I yelled at the refs, I yelled at the kids, I cheered for the kids, I clapped. It was just a great, exciting time in my life, and I'm just so glad that I had that opportunity to watch Andy play basketball and be a super fan for him and the rest of the team.
In the summer of 2004, Andy decided to finish his career at Trinity, but not without leaving behind a legacy of tough-as-nails, applesauce-making, post-playing. Will we ever see the MEUL trotting down a basketball court again? Time will tell. There are rumors of an aggressive slam-dunking post making waves in Trinity's intramural league, but are these just rumors? All we can know for sure is that the man known as the MEUL, Andy Vander Meulen, will never be forgotten.
Our most recent highlight with basketball with Andy was going up to watch Trinity Western play Georgia. And of course, Andy wasn't playing this year. And we got it all done. And he's going, "Man, these bleachers are hard." And I'm going, "Yeah, well, this is what we've done for like a bazillion years and about a bazillion games. But I wouldn't give it up for anything because I sure enjoyed it."
This is so funny.